In Steven Spielberg's 2004 film, The Terminal, Tom Hanks plays an Eastern European man who's stranded at JFK for months, and while doing so, he keeps a promise to his late father. He sets out to obtain the only missing autograph of the 57 jazz musicians assembled in the iconic black and white photo, A Great Day in Harlem, from 1958. The missing autograph is that of our next composer, Benny Golson, who will be 92 in January. Stablemates was the tune that brought Benny Golson's talents to the attention of the jazz world at large. His childhood friend, John Coltrane, originally gave the chart to Miles Davis, who recorded it in 1955. Soon afterwards, Dizzy Gillespie hired Golson for a big band tour and commissioned an arrangement, which they recorded in 1957. This arrangement was written by Mike Kamouf, Stablemates.
One, two, three.
as Dave Brubeck composed In Your Own Sweet Way in 1952 for his wife, Iola, and it has become a jazz standard, recorded by Miles Davis, John Coltrane, Sonny Rollins, and many others. Its commercial release was on the 1956 solo album Brubeck Plays Brubeck. The first quartet version appeared on the 1956 album Dave Brubeck and J and K at Newport, issued on the Columbia label. In the liner notes to Time Signatures, Brubeck wrote, quote, "For the first few years, the quartet played almost all standards until one day Paul Desmond said to me, 'We've got to hire somebody to write some material for us.' I said, 'Paul, are you kidding? I'll write two tunes in half an hour.' I wrote In Your Own Sweet Way and The Waltz that night. From then on, we started doing my material a lot more." Arranger John Wasson creates a variety of jazz ensemble colors and harmonies in his version of In Your Own Sweet Way. Clifford Brown's death in a car accident at the age of 25 was one of the great tragedies in jazz history. Already ranking with Dizzy Gillespie and Miles Davis as one of the top trumpeters in jazz, Brownie was still improving in 1956. This jazz trumpet legend composed Tiny Capers, and arranger Carl Straumann adapted this bebop classic into a fantastic chart for big band. The opening melody is stated by tenor and trumpet, and the clarity of melodies balanced with counter melodies is wonderful. Clifford Brown's playing, improvisations, and compositions shine like a beacon to this day. Here is Tiny Capers. Johnny Mercer and Victor Schertzinger composed Tangerine in 1941, and it soon became a jazz standard. It was introduced to a broad audience in the 1942 film The Fleet's Inn, and subsequently recorded by over 100 artists, from Dr. John to Frank Sinatra, from Tony Bennett to Harry Connick Jr. It's arranged here in a funky New Orleans style by John Wasson. Here's Tangerine.
Thank you.
Joe Henderson may have been one of the most significant tenor saxophonists to emerge in the 1960s because of his solo work, compositions, and collaborations with leading jazz artists of the day. Henderson composed the title song for trumpeter Blue Mitchell's album Step Lightly, which was recorded in 1963 at the legendary Van Gelder Studio in New Jersey. He also played tenor saxophone on that album. Mike Kamuf wrote this arrangement of Step Lightly.
Thank you.
Joe Henderson is one of the great jazz saxophonists and a composer who wrote a handful of tunes known by almost every jazz student. Record on Me, or Remember Me, is a jazz standard written by Henderson. It was introduced on his debut album, Page One, in 1963. This album also featured the first recording of the jazz standard Blue Bossa, written by trumpeter Kenny Dorham. From his New York Times obituary, quote, Mr. Henderson was unmistakably modern. Quote, Joe had one foot in the present, the other in the future, and he was just a step away from immortality, said the saxophonist Benny Golson. This arrangement was written by Mike Camouf. Record on Me.
One, two, three.